everyone, it's Diane here. I wanted to go ahead today and create a quick tutorial for you showing you how I made my acorn leaf that I shared with you the other day. What you're going to want to do is open up your BES4 software. You get this little welcome screen. We're going to close this off. Right now you do not have a working screen here. What you'll need to do is go up to the top left on this white paper here where it says new, select that. Now we have a screen that we can work with. Then go on to the internet and find an image that you want to trace. I just put in oak leaf clip art. Bring up something that you like. And when you find an image you like, with your mouse, right click, select save image as, and then save it to a location that you'll be able to find it later. I've already got one saved that I'm going to use. Saving it to your desktop makes it a quick, easy place to find it. Then go back to your software here, and we're going to go to view. And then backdrop tool, load backdrop. Okay, go to that location where you saved your image. Here is where I've got mine. Open it, and it's going to bring that image in for you. I'm going to go to the home screen and zoom in a little bit on here. What you want to do then is look at your image and kind of make a choice as to where you want to start and stop your stitching. And then from there, you will go to the tools panel up here, and we're going to select the line tool. And you want to make sure you make that one continuous line. So visually, kind of planning in your head where you want to start and stop will help when you're going to draw your project out. So with the left mouse, select the line tool, and you're going to get a little crosshatch. And then with the left mouse, click that, and now it's bringing here like a little edit button right there. And then you're going to keep pressing the left mouse button and just follow the shape around to create your design. You don't want to make too many edit buttons, but you want enough of them that it's going to create the shape that you want. We're just going to follow this around, bring this in. And you can, you know, have something as very simple as this or something a little more complex. This is what I use a lot for creating my applique shapes. I'm not good at drawing. I couldn't just, you know, visually look at a blank screen and draw something out. Some people may be able to just look at a blank screen and draw something out. I do much better with what I call tracing out a design. We just go along like this. Now I can hit the select button and then go back to my edit shape tool. I'm going to select the close here. Okay, let's select this. Close shape. Why is it not doing it? Close the shape. There we go. So it closes the shape up here. Okay, we're going to go back to the edit select tool, and I'm going to shrink this down a little bit. With my left mouse, I'm going to select everything here. And then with the right part of the mouse, I'm going to select smooth. And that is then going to curve all my curves and make them nice and pretty and curved. Then we can zoom in, and as you zoom in, you can look at your shapes and see if there's anything you need to edit. And if there is, you've got your edit shape tool selected, you can select an edit button, and then has these little handles here that pop up. You can easily, with the left mouse, select one of them little handles and maneuver them around to edit the shape. You can also, with the left mouse, touch one of these little edit buttons and move them around, right and left, wherever, to reposition them how you might like them to be. So you just go around and finish editing the shape to fine-tune it to what it is you like. And you can also add in or remove some of these edit buttons if you need to be able to help edit your shape. So you just take a little time to do this. One of those things, maybe put some music on and just relax. Some projects will maybe take a little more time than others. Okay, so I'm not going to mess with this too much for this purpose here. Now what we want to do is create the stem. So click off that, go back to the tools, get the line tool again, because now we're going to create our stem here as a separate stitch line. With this, again, think about where it is you're going to want the machine to stitch. I'm going to start here at the bottom, and I want one continuous stitch. I don't want it to keep starting and stopping. So I don't want to start here and have it come up to here and stop and break my thread or cut my thread and then come back here and go up a little bit and go this way and stop. What I'm going to do is have it come up, have it stitch back down to here, have it go over to the right and stitch back again to here, follow the stem up, come back down, go over here to the right. So we want one continuous flowing stitching. So we're going to start here again with the left mouse, make a click, and then just follow the line up. I'm going to zoom in a little bit here so you can see better where I'm doing. Okay, and then if you happen to click off on here, you're going to end up or double click or something. You could end up breaking your line and then you'd have to start over again. So just be careful. Just follow this along. Now, I found out if I get to the end here and I want to turn around, I need to put an edit point and one more just slightly past this one and then come back. Otherwise, it will stop the design closer to here instead of coming up and coming back. Then what you're going to want to do, try and zoom in a little bit and follow as close as you can on your original line and click as close as you can on the original edit button that you made, because you want that stitching line to stitch right on top of each other. If you have your stitching lines fairly apart from one another, you're going to notice it when it stitches out on your project. So we're going to just keep making our little edit points on my project. Now, when I get to the end, go past it just a tiny bit, put one, and then come back. And we're going to do is come back to these and fine tune them. Now, I want this to come all the way back to this point here so that it's going to make a nice smooth line continuing up the center of this stem here. Okay, just keep making your edit points, following your design. And you don't have to follow as a, you know, a design exactly. You know, put a little of your personality into it if you want. You know, use this as a guideline. And you can, you know, change the shape of something a little bit to what you might like. I'm going to keep, again, put these points on top of the prior one. And then I'm going to show you in just a moment how we're going to fine tune this a little bit. And you're going to go over to the right here. Get to the point, go past it just a little bit and put one, and then right back on top of the prior one. And then back up to the center here. Okay, I'm going to zoom this in a little bit here. Now, I could make this stop here, but I'm not going to, because in this area here on these stems, you notice they go one direction and back, which means it's got a double stitching. This would only have a single stitching here, so it wouldn't have the same look. So I want to go ahead and continue following this all the way back down, so that way when it stitches out, it's going to have a nice continuous matching look. We're going to continue bringing this all the way down, lining up with these prior points. So when you get to here, you're going to have like 4 points that we're going to need to go in and edit to make sure that they all line up nice and neat, and I'm going to show you now how we're going to do that. Okay, so what we're going to do is we can go to the home and we can take our little magnifying glass. Whoops. Hit select because it's going to keep making points. Go here. It made 1 point extra that I want. So I'm going to edit shape tool here. Okay. And I'm going to right click. I'm going to delete that because I really didn't want that one there. Okay. Now you can see how I've got 4 different spots here. Let's zoom in a little more. The more you zoom in, the more you can see how far apart those are. You go back to tools, edit, and then we're going to start bring all of these in alignment with one another so that you're going to have a really nice smooth stitching line. Okay, and then just follow around on the shape to all of those edit points and bring those points close together. Unfortunately, my mouse does not like to zoom in and out very well, so I've got to, you can go here and bring everything back into the screen so you can see it. I've got to use the magnifying glass to get to see things better. Okay, there, see, there's one there. Tools and edit, so we want to get these two. These, I'm going to go ahead, because they're at the end, leave them just a little bit of apart. Home, bring that back down some. So this is going to take you a little time. Just be patient. Line these up. We want to get this one here so that it's on top of that other line. And find where those points are. I know when I scroll around like this, it takes a little while. Yeah. It's just faster just to grab the magnifying glass, bring them in. And when it's zoomed out, they look like they're right on top of each other, but when you get it zoomed in, you can see right away they're not. Okay, let's get these two together. Just keep selecting and edit and move these guys around till you get it lined up. Here again, this is where we've got that area where the stems from both sides and the center all want to join together. So this is important here that you get these all in alignment with one another as well as you can. Okay, that looks pretty good there. Let's go up to the right. Line those up. Here. Go up the middle here. So just keep working around lining everything up. Okay. I don't want to spend forever doing this for you. So then I'm going to change the color on this so it makes it its own separate. Let's find another color that's good contrast. Okay. I'm going to change that to the orange. Okay. And I'm going to lock this for just a second so I can select all of these. Well, I want to select the ones in the, let's see here, edit shape tool. I want to select the ones in the middle here, kind of, and smooth those out. If you hit smooth on the pointed ones, you're going to have a round going there, and that's not something you want. So I just want to smooth these out. Whoa, okay. Do you want to do that? Hit Control Z and fix, it'll put it back. Okay, this is all looking pretty good. At this point now, click off the screen here. I'm gonna unlock this. We're going to, with the left mouse, or you can select both of them holding the shift key and select everything here. Right click. Copy, right click again, and paste. And it's going to make another set right on top of this one. See that little hand there? We're going to grab that, and we're going to move everything over. You always want to make a copy because this is completely editable. So if when I make some further edits to this, I mess it up, I can go back to this to do whatever I need to if I've messed this one up. And at this point, too, if you have a computer that tends to freeze up or shut down on you, go ahead and save this at this point. So we're going to say File, Save As, and then let's say Oak Leaf. Make sure it's a BRF. That means it will be editable. If you save it as a PES, it will not longer be editable. So BRF, will make it editable. So we're going to save that. So that way we can get it again if we need to. Okay, so now what we can do is select all of this, and we're going to now say convert to applique. And hopefully it will work. And voila, there is your applique shape. Say at this point, then we can go to the view and the backdrop tool and hit the show, and it kind of like hides it. We don't need that anymore. So now we can see our shape here. You can leave this as a satin stitch if you like, but I think it's kind of fun to do some other things with it. You've got over here on the right side a variety of choices. On mine, I did a blanket stitch and then select apply. Now, I'm gonna zoom in here. On this, I'm gonna open this up. Can't really see these yellow colors, so let's change them to some darker colors so you can see those other colors there. So can you see these others? Okay. With what I did for mine, I want to do is this line here, I want to, you can leave that like that, or you can push it over to the side here a little bit. It's kind of up to you. You can adjust where those lines go to. I need to hit select. Here, I guess that's good. Now at this point too, let's do 3D draw there. That makes it a lot easier to see. Right here, that shows you what it's gonna look like when it's gonna stitch. And if you want this line a little closer, you can go over here and adjust that. If you wanna see that much of it or not, let's hit backspace and let's change that to a 3 over here and hit apply and see what it looks like. It puts it a little closer here. I like that a little better for what it is that did with mine. You can see that around. Now also you can do is, depending on the size of your project, you can adjust how close or how far apart these are. Mine was kind of a small size, so I decided that the stitch length I wanted to be a little different. So let's try. I know that when you do the numbers certain ways, they are closer or farther apart, because that's the stitch length, okay, the density. Let's try this, 2 point. There, see, I've got more stitches now. So you can have more or less. That might be a little too many. So let's try 2.5 and apply. There, I like that a lot better. I think that's gonna secure my fabric a little better than what the original was. Now, let's reduce this down a little bit here so we can see the center stem some. Now this is kind of fun to do. Instead of having a satin stitch here, let's go play with the motifs. You got a motif here. And then there are all kinds of fun different shapes here. So look at these and see if there's something that you like. And then, you know, play around with different ones. I think this was the one that I used, was an M047. So you select a motif, and I did, I believe, made that a 0, and then apply. So let's zoom this in a little bit. So there is a motif. You can change this as well to make it, you know, a different length and, you know, pattern size. What if we change that to a 3.5 and see what that is? So you know, it's a matter of just taking and playing with stitches. Let's do this one here, 4 point. Some of them, I'm not exactly quite sure what they do. Okay, so let's zoom in here some more. I want you to see, this is where we can still edit this because we haven't made it an actual converted to stitches. This is where you can see if your, let's do this. If I drag this over here and select off, see, that what it would be, what it would look like if you didn't take the time to line them up on top of one another. So I'm going to select Control Z to put that back in place. So that's why it's important to take the time now to look at where these stitches are. See, those are maybe a little off right there. I can hit the Edit Shape tool. And, you know, this would be where you can, you know, edit it and go, that made that worse. So that might be better left alone. So let's select this. And, you know, just play with different stitches and see what it might interest you. And you get, you know, a whole different kind of a look of what it is you're going to have your design look back like. Let's go ahead and zoom this in. And this was a really nice shape that I did on another project of mine. Not necessarily appropriate for this, but a different project I did. That was a really nice shape. Let's see what this one here might look like. See, that could be kind of cute. So you can see up here, see here how that doesn't line up? We go to the tools, the Edit Shape tool, and you see how this is off. So grab that, bring that over, and then when you click off the area, see how that brought that in much better alignment? So that's why it's important that you line those edits up so that you get a nice image. So I'm going to select this again. I'm going to go back to that one that I liked. This here, M47. Select Apply. Let's shrink this down a little bit so you can see it better. So that's pretty much what I did here. Now, this here is now still artwork. Or actually, this one here. So this artwork is something that is always editable. The applique is still editable. Now with the outside here, I want to leave that as an applique because I'm actually putting, you know, a couple of layers of fabric together. I'm going to have the front top layer and then I'm going to have a back layer. So I want those layers of applique. But this, I don't need to have it stitching it out as an applique. So what we're going to do is go over here and select this, right click, and then tell it to preserve as stitches. And now I've got these three different layers. So I'm going to delete this top one, delete this next one, and then now I'm left with these stitches. So it's going to stitch out like this. See here? There we go. Stitching out. All one nice smooth stitching. Now, if you want to have maybe an extra placement stitch for yourself to know where you're going to lay your fabric down, something you can do, copy this one. So Control C or right click and copy and then paste, and you've got one exactly on top of the other. Select this, say preserve as stitches, and then we're going to go ahead and delete this one because we don't want it to have a blanket stitch. We just want to have a plain stitch. We're going to then drag this up to the top So then this would then be like a placement stitch on your in your hoop. Then you would have the applique to be able to do the layers of fabric and then your stem in here. So then what I'm going to do is select all three of these, copy it. You're going to want to then have a new page and say paste. This is now going to be your embroidery design, okay? You've got your new page, you've got all of your pieces here. Then you're going to go ahead and say file, save as. This is where you're going to save it as a PES. If you save it as a BRF without changing the name, you're going to override your editable design. So give it a different name, whatever you want, but then make sure you save it as a PES file or whatever file type for whatever machine type that your machine takes. And then, so I would save it as a PES. And, you know, I can name it Oak Leaf because I know I've changed the file type, and then save. Okay, if it says does not fit the hoop, oh, why doesn't it? This is where, too, look at the size here. You can, you need to select the proper size hoop. Let's go back over here a second. At this point here, too, and you've got this, look at your size. You can, without distorting anything, say select shift and this corner here. You can control Z. Let me select both of these together. There we go. So I hit shift and this corner. I can take and make this as big or as small as I want without distorting the size of the shape. Once you have something that, say, preserved as stitches, if I was to just take this here, let's do a copy and paste of this. Say then, if I go and you can distort a design. This one didn't come out too bad, but sometimes they'll look really bad. Let's delete this. What you would want to do so you don't distort anything is grab everything, right click and power copy it if you needed to make it larger or smaller. But you're best off with making this the correct size first. And you can still edit this, like I said, because it is still a applique. But once you convert to stitches, then you can no longer. So have one as your BRF that you can edit. Have one as your PES that is going to be your actual design that you're going to put in your machine to stitch. So I hope this helps you all, ladies, and create something and share with the rest of us. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.